फ्रेंड्स, नमस्ते टू ऑल ऑफ यू। आई एम डॉक्टर सुहास कुमार शेट्टी एंड वेलकम टू द वेबिनार सीरीज बीइंग ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय नेपाल आयुर्वेद मेडिकल स्टूडेंट सोसाइटी। आई एम डॉक्टर सुहास कुमार शेट्टी, डिड माय मास्टर्स एंड पीएचडी इन मानस रोग from SDM College of Ayurveda and Hospital, Hasan. And I have been the faculty in the department of Manas Roga for the last 16 years. And I'm presenting heading the department of Manas Roga at SDM College of Ayurveda and Hospital, Hasan. And I'm also the Dean of Research at the institution. So once again, a very warm welcome to all of you for today's webinar series being organized by Nepal Ayurvedic Medical Students Society. Today happens to be a very special day. As you all know, today is World Health Day. And as you all know that we are being fighting against World Health Day, as you all know, is support nurses and midwives. As we all know that they play a very important role in the healthcare management. And rightly said in Ayurveda that paricharaka is an important component of the treatment. So that's the reason why WHO has dedicated this year's World Health Day for the nursing staff and all the supporting staff who are in the forefront and doing a great job in counteracting various types of disorders, not only in the present days of COVID pandemic, but the entire spectrum of disorders where they play a key role in the health management. And one more important thing that I'd like to share today is this. I really appreciate the office bearers of the Nepal Ayurvedic Medical Students Society who have been organizing series of webinars where people are able to share their experiences with the world about some of the common conditions which have been managed by Ayurveda. And this happens to be the 14th among this series. And 14 is a very special number, especially in Hindu mythology. As you all know that Lord Rama returned back after his Vanvasa, or after a great struggle after 14 years. And during this mythological story, we also come across probably the first instances of lockdown, where Lord Lakshmana puts the Lakshmana Rekha around Sita Mate, but as you all know, she comes out of this Lakshmana Rekha, and rest is history. So probably in this tough time, when there is a havoc happening all over the world with this condition called as corona disease or coronavirus disease, we always have seen the negative aspect, or the how this disease has been causing various types of mortality and morbidity across, not only in country like India, Nepal, but the entire world, including the developed countries like America and the European countries. So one side we see the negative aspect of this disease. Probably this is also, if you look at the positive aspect of this condition, because we are moving at a very fast pace that people do not have time to think about themselves. Probably this is the time that God has given us to take care about ourselves, to take care about our family, to take care about the people around us, to give a pause, to reset our goals, to reset the ambition the priorities of life so that we can restart again with a new momentum. Probably initially we thought of covering the psychosocial care in COVID virus condition in this presentation, but later on the organizers wanted me to talk something about an overview of the management of common mental disorders with Ayurveda. So probably some other day, definitely I'll be very happy to be back with giving you guidelines on the management or the psychosocial care that we can give in cases of the COVID virus. So let me appreciate and acknowledge the efforts taken by the office bearers of Nepal Ayurveda Medical Student Society for organizing series of this webinar. And I'd like to personally acknowledge and thank for inviting me and probably giving me an opportunity to share of my experiences of the management of the common mental disorders. And let me confess that the presentation that I'm doing here is not my individual experiences, but the experience of my entire department, my teachers, my colleagues, all my alumni and my postgraduate students. So it's a teamwork which is very important in the management of psychiatric disorders. So probably let me take a few more minutes before I could share my screen with the slide presentation on the Ayurvedic management of common mental disorders. So in this presentation, probably I'll be trying to touch some of the important major mental disorders like schizophrenia, depression, anxiety, epilepsy, and probably also try to touch upon a few aspects related with anxiety and insomnia. So we're going to touch important Anga, among the Ashtanga called as Bhuta Vidya or Graha Chikitsa in this session. The Bhuta Vidya or Graha Chikitsa encompasses all the psychological and physical disorders which are because of various external causes. And not only external causes, but also includes all the arthas which are both external as well as internal. We talk about two arthas. One is Indriya arthas, which refers to all the external stresses, environmental stresses, which are outside. And the Mano arthas, which we talk in terms of the emotional stresses, the psychological stresses, which are within. So all the disorders, all psychological and the physical disorders, which could happen because of various external or environmental stresses and emotional stresses, are under the encompassment of the condition called as Bhuta Vidya. I'll be talking about the management of So welcome back. So I'll be talking about the management of common mental disorders in Ayurveda. So the common mental disorders, so basically when you talk about mental health, so we are talking about a state of well-being which is characterized by an ability to understand himself, where an individual realizes his potentials and is able to manage or able to work with being able to be productive and being fruitful, and also is able to contribute to the society. Basically, the health. So we are going to talk about the common mental disorders like schizophrenia, epilepsy, depression, and the substance abuse. The common mental disorders in Ayurveda would include Unmada, Apasmara, Vishada, and Madhatya. So coming to Unmada, Unmada refers to all those mental disorders. Unmada refers to all those mental disorders which an individual has abnormalities in his mano, buddhi, sanya, jnana, smriti, bhakti, shila, chesta, and achara. So Unmada is a spectrum of mental disorders which includes an abnormality related with various psychological functionings. So these mental faculties may include manas, which includes perception, buddhi, called as judgment, sanya jnana, meaning to orientation, smriti, referring to the memory, bhakti, various forms of desires, shila, the habits and temperaments, chesta, the psychosocial activities, including the speech, and achara, referring to the personal and social standards. So all those disorders, all the psychological disorders, where you could see abnormalities of any of these mental faculties is called as Unmada. So whenever we are talking about Unmada, we always classify them into two broad classification as Dosha Unmada and Bhuta Unmadas. So Dosha Unmadas are those types of psychological disorders which could be easily understood in terms of their causative factors, in terms of their doshas, dhatu, agni, etc. Like the set parameters can be set, like this condition is because of vata vriddhi or kapha vriddhi, etc. Whereas bhutonmadas are those set of psychological disorders which may not be understood easily on basis of the doshic parameters. So that's the reason why the management of dosha unmadas are through yukti vyapasha chikitsa, and the management of bhuta unmada is through deva vyapasha chikitsa. So if you look into the three basic karanas, as told, like dvayana api doshanam trivida prakopa karanam tadyata asatmyanyata sanyogaha prajnyaparadaha parinamascheti. So these are the three basic causes, either for the psychological disorders or the physical disorders. So basically this prajnaparadha is the cause for the vibhramsha, and that causes various cognitive impairment. Asatmendhyata sanyoga is a cause for dhriti vibhramsha, thereby leading to various emotional disorders. And parinama, or the time, refers or deranges the smriti, leading to smriti vibhramsha or various types of memory and degenerative types of disorders. So if you look at the causes of the mental disorders, we can classify them into three basic causes, which includes the predisposing causes, like hereditary causes, the bad childhood experiences, then the precipitating causes, which could be loss of a dear one, a loss of a loved one, or loss of a job, new working experiences, etc. And perpetuating causes, which includes all those causes which maintains the disease, maybe the psychological support that we have at home, or the office support that we have at the occupational level or the workplace, etc., all comes under the perpetuating or the maintaining causes. So if you classify or if you differentiate between the basic causes of the Nija Unmada and Agansuri Unmada, Nija Unmadas are caused due to various dietary habits because of personality disorders, genetic factors, etc. Whereas the agantu is, most of them, it is unknown, or the basic root cause could be prajnaparadha. So it could, so the causes for Unmada could encompass various type of dietary habits because of various psychological disturbances, vegadharanas, and especially because of various psychosubstance abuses like alcoholism, cannabis, etc. may be the cause. Regarding the onset, the Agamsya Unmada is sudden onset, whereas Nija Unmada may become gradual in due course of time. And if you look at the Pururupa of Agamsya and Nija Unmadas, generally the Agamsya Unmadas are characterized by aggressive, impulsive, behavior, restlessness, or a person could have a sudden or unexplainable transformation in his personalities. And there could be some, various types of nightmares or terrors, etc. Whereas in Nija Unmadas, it is more of a physical or psychological causes. Regarding the Lakshanas, in Agamsu Unmada, there could be aggression, violence, excessive sexual orientation. Sometimes they could be very spiritual, etc. based on the type of Unmada. Whereas in case of Nija Unmadas, it follows a set patterns. Like in case of Vajra Unmada, there will be too much talkative. In case of Pitta Unmada, they will be very aggressive, either causing harm to themselves or others. Whereas people of Kapha Unmadas will be very silent, isolated, like to be alone. So it follows a set parameters as per the doshas. So that is where, if you look at the management of this Nija and Agamsu Unmadas, for Nija Unmadas, Yuktivapasha Chikitsa or the pharmacological treatment plays a major role. Whereas in case of Agamsu Unmadas, the Daivapasha Chikitsa plays a major role. So all the three categories of treatment, Yuktivapasha Chikitsa, Daivapasha Chikitsa and the Satvaja Chikitsa has a major role to play in the management of Unmada. So let's see what's the basic difference between Yuktivapasha and Daivapasha in the management of Unmadas. So whenever the causes are known, whenever you are able to assess the doshas, you have to go with the Yuktivapasha Chikitsa. When the causes are not clear, when the doshic manifestation is not clear, you go with Daivapasha Chikitsa. So that is where the Yuktivapasha Chikitsa are dosha pratyanika chikitsas acting specifically on the doshas, whereas Daivapasha Chikitsa act directly on the diseases or their vyadhi pratyanika chikitsas. So it could include antaparimarjana, bhariparimarjana, shastrapranidhana in cases of a Yuktivapasha Chikitsa, whereas various types of non-pharmacological rituals, faith-based therapies are the main line of treatment in case of Daivapasha Chikitsas. So, especially the Panchakarma or the Shodhana Chikitsa plays a major role in the treatment of the psychological disorders, especially the Unmada Chikitsa, because it is said that whenever the Hridaya, Indriya, Shiras and the Koshtas are purified, it purifies the psychological aspects. Or the Manaprasadana happens by the purification of the Indriya, Shiras and the Koshta. So that is why various pharmacological or the Panchakarma therapies like Amana, Virechana, Basti, Nasya, Raktamokshana will cause the purification of the Shiras, Hridaya, Indriya and the Koshta, thereby causing the purification in the psychological functionings. So we talk a lot about the Murni Tailas in the treatment of psychological disorders, maybe the Abhyanga, Seka, Pichu and the Basti. And all of them play a major role in the treatment of psychological aspects. Just to add how exactly this could be useful in the treatment of psychological disorders. So there are various hypotheses which I like to just put forward of how these are helpful in the management of psychological disorders. These could act through drug absorption, like they could be passive diffusion or like through hydrated stratum corneum, affinity towards the lipophilic and hydrophilic compounds are present. And as you all know, there's the highest skin permeability in the scalp. So that is that the drug gets absorbed. And also there is a physical effect of the Shirodhara. And by doing the Shirodhara, it leads to vasodilatation, thereby increasing the circulation. And especially it has an effect on the central nervous system, because the sensory inputs that are there from the external and internal environment will reach the hypothalamus. And it also has a great anxiolytic or anti-anxiety effects, because it facilitates the inhibitory presynaptic action of gamma aminobutyric acid and various sedative activities which are present in the limbic system. It also is a potent antidepressant, because it will act just like monoamino oxidase inhibitors, and it will increase the active non-adrenaline in the synaptic gap. And it also will stimulate as effects on the autonomic nervous system by blocking the alpha adrenergic effect. And as you all know that there are various types of marmas present in the shiras, like stapani, Kshepa, Shankha, Adhipati, etc. It will stimulate the various marmas present in the kshiras, and also it has an effect on the Agnya Chakra. So we use various types of herbs in the management of Unmada, like Jyotishmati, Shankapushpi, Kushmanda, etc. And all of them are, as you know, comes in the major category of Medya Rasayanas. So Medya Rasayanas are those group of drugs which are helpful for the imprinting or improving the memory as well as intellect. So we can categorize the Medya Rasayanas into two basic categories. One, which are Shita Virya and Madhura Vipaka, like Yashtimadhu, Brahmi, Shankapushpi, and they promote the functioning of Tarpaka Kapha, thereby helping in the Dharana Karma or the retention of the cognition. Whereas those which are Ushna Virya and Tiktarasa, like Guduchi, Jyotishmati, Vacha, etc., they promote the Sadhaka Pitta and enhances the Grahana and Smarana Shakti, like grasping power as well as memory power. So those which are Shita Virya and Madhura Vipaka helps in Dharana Karma. Those which are Ushna Virya and Tiktarasa are helping in Grahana and Smarana Shakti. So Charaka mentions about four important Medya Rasayanas. And let's see what exactly is the importance of these four Medya Rasayanas and what's the importance of the form in which it has to be used. So I start with Shankapushpi with the intention that Charaka mentions that Shankapushpi is the best among all the Medya Rasayanas. And it is said to be used in the form of the whole plant in the form of Kalka. The scientific reason behind this is the active principle Convolulin is present in the whole plant. And this active principle is responsible for blocking the cholinergic muscarinic receptors, and they potentiate the memory enhancers, which are deficits in various disorders like Alzheimer's, memory disorders, ADHD, autism spectrum disorders, etc. And the extract of the whole plant is prone to increase the neuropeptide synthesis in brain protein content, and thereby increasing in the acquisition efficiency. The ability to acquire the new knowledge is increased by use of Shankapushpi. Mandukaparni, as you all know, should be used in Swarasa, and that too the leaf extract, because the leaf extract has highest amount of the active principles of Mandukaparni. The Asiatica sites, which is active principles, is highest in the leaf as compared with roots and petioles. And the aqueous extract prevents the cognitive deficits and specially helps in retention of the memory. It also possesses the active principles which are known to be neuroprotective and potent antioxidant. Kuduchi, especially, we advise them to use in the form of kwatha, and especially the kwatha of the stem, because the active principle berberin is abundantly found in stem, and this is the one which has the acetyl cholesterase inhibitory action over the individuals, and it also prevents the oxidative damage, and it also lowers the lipids which hampers the cerebral blood flow. So it is a very potent, and nowadays like it is also a very potent medicine for the antiviral as well. Yashtimadhu is said to be useful as a Yashtimadhu churna along with the milk. Glabridin, which is isoflavonine, that comes in, or it is hyperpotent in the hydrophobic extract. It is proven to said that it is very beneficial in the cerebral injuries, especially in stroke, as it is proven neuroprotective. And the Yashtimadhu is also said to be very useful as to retain the memory. And suppose someone wants to retain the memory, Yashtimadhu is said to be very beneficial. So just I have tried to highlight that the four major Medya Rasayanas and its forms are equally important in the management of various psychological disorders. Along with that, the common compound formulation which we use in Unmada includes Kalyanakagrita and Mahakalyanakagrita, which are commonly used in case of Vata Pradhana Unmada, Brahmi Grita and Kushmana Grita used in Pitta dominant type of Unmada, and Panchagavya Grita, Lashanadi Grita, Apara Lashanadi Grita, which are very beneficial in the management of kaphajonmaja. So along with that, sattvavacha plays a very important role after the initial management of the use of the yuktivapasha chikitsa. Sattvavacha chikitsa are all those psychophysical exercises which are designed to achieve a regulatory mechanism or a balance or equilibrium over the human psyche, especially in dealing with various types of indriyarthas and manoarthas. So sattvavacha is beneficial for management of environmental stresses, which are indriyarthas, and the manoarthas, which includes the emotional stresses. So it helps in reduction of the mind, to restrain the mind from various unwholesome preoccupations, stresses, etc., from various forms of therapeutic forms like the dhairya atmadi vijnanam mano dosha ushadam param or manaso jnana vijnanam dhairya smriti samadhi bhi. So the chikitsa in unmada is also divided into dravyabhuta chikitsa and adravyabhuta chikitsas. So dravyabhuta chikitsas includes all pharmacological therapies which will affect on the sthula sharira, and adravyabhuta chikitsas includes all non-pharmacological therapies which could have an effect on the sukshma sharira. So various forms of upaya chikitsas or adravyabhuta chikitsas include bhayadarshana, vismapana, vismarana, vada, etc. So they can be classified as negative modalities and positive modalities like dvesha bhedena and ichha bhedena. Dvesha bhedena refers to negative modalities and ichha bhedena refers to the positive modalities. Like the negative modalities includes bhayadarshana, kshobana, etc. And positive modalities includes swapna sammana, harshana, vismapana, vismarana, etc. So I'll just give one example like how we can use that therapies in the management. Like bhayadarshana, it could be used in case of performance anxiety, alcohol addictions, anger outburst, etc. So what we do is we have various types of therapies called as exposure therapies and flooding therapies. I'm just giving examples like exposure therapies where the people are exposed to the categories of people who suffer with various disorders. Like for example, an alcohol addiction people or alcohol dependency people can be exposed to people suffering with chronic liver disorders, cirrhosis, ascites, etc. And also we have a therapies called as the flooding therapies, where the anxiety is initiated and then probably replaced by the positive reinforcement. Moving on to the next set of disease called as apasmara. So apasmara is a set of disorders which is characterized by the convulsion or the seizures, and there is always a debate that whether this is a psychological disorders or a neurological disorders, but definitely various psychological factors like fear, anxiety, sorrow, etc., can be a triggering factors for the manifestation of the disease. So it's episodic disorders, so that's why we call it as management of apasmara roga sometimes and apasmara vega. So apasmara roga is that condition when they are not in acute episodic or seizures, whereas apasmara vega is when an individual has an apt or has an epileptic attacks. Okay, so it's important that when you're managing such conditions, we need to take care whether you're treating the acute attack or you're treating the condition well. And most of the time, in most of the more than 90% of the cases, you are not treating the acute cases of epilepsy or acute cases of apasmara, because most of them they come with asymptomatic or in between the attacks when they do not have the attacks. But if at all they have the attacks, one should take care, utmost care, to see that you can prevent the injuries, you can prevent the asphyxia, you can prevent the tongue bite, and see that a person gets sufficient aeration through the manifestations. And regarding the treatment, you know, and the causes can be from various ages, starting from children, where it could be infectious causes, or it could be because of febrile convulsions. In case of the adolescents, it could be because of the substance abuse. In middle age, it could be because of the organic pathology. In old age, it could be because of the degenerative changes. So this epilepsy can happen at any age, starting from the pediatrics to geriatrics. And the main causes could be fear, anxiousness, exhaustion, sleep deprivation, alcoholic consumption, etc. may be the major triggering factors for the patient suffering with. So one need to be very careful with sleep deprivation and use of alcohol in the prevention of psychological disorders, and especially to take care about the not to drive, not to go for swimming between the cases, like cases where they are told not to go for driving at least for 5 to 8 months. Maximum they can go up to 1 hour of driving every day. And care is given for the woman, pregnant lady, breastfeeding, and those people who have cognitive or emotional deficits. The treatment, as you all know, should be based on the whether you're giving an acute treatment for the attack or whether it is in between the attacks. And many times patients approaching you could already be on some anti-epileptic drugs. It is advisable not to stop these medications. One need to continue these medications, not abruptly stop them. Maybe one can start with IV treatment, do all forms of shoulder therapies, taper them during at least for 6 months or 1 year of time, and based on patient's compliance, one can always taper and stop. But whenever patient comes to you for the first time, it is not advisable to stop, taper the anti-epileptic medications. Not only anti-epileptics, any of the medications which are used in the treatment of psychological disorders. People get a lot of repeated attacks. It's very important to give a psychological support, because very often we come across the cases in our OPD where, in spite of taking the treatment, in spite of all the proper management, but still they get the attacks. So it's very important to counsel the patient as well as the family members to take care about their conditions. So especially to avoid the substance abuse, and when one need to refer such patients to the specialist, especially when the epilepsy is in children, pregnant lady and elderly, when the epilepsy lasts for more than 5 to 10 minutes, when there is loss of consciousness, severe distress, etc. So in spite of being on medications, if there is a repeated seizures, probably that's a time when they should be referred to a specialist in Manasroga, or especially a neurologist should be referred. Coming to the next disease of the substance abuse, especially the alcohol abuse. So there are three important steps that need to be followed in the management of substance abuse or any drug addictions. Like we call it as SAT, where S stands for screening, A stands for assessment, and T stands for treatment. So initially you need to screen the type of the drugs, whether it is a single drug or multiple drug abuse, whether the patient is having intoxication, whether it is withdrawal symptoms, tolerance, dependency, etc. Then the whole thorough assessment in terms of the physical and laboratory profile need to be done, and then the treatment. So especially you have to assess the serum amylase, pancreatic isoamylase and serum lipase, because very commonly the chronic alcoholic and substance abuse could have problem with pancreatitis, which could be very severe sometimes. So it's always important that along with the routine blood investigation, lipid profile and liver function test, also assess the serum amylase and serum lipase. So based on various long-term observation in our department, we have probably tried to come out with the biomarkers which could be indicative of the madhya and the ojas. As you all know, the madhya has the quality quite similar to that of the visha and quite opposite to that of ojas. So we try to have come out with some biological markers of these two factors. For madhya, we have tried to go with GGT, gamma glutamyl transferase. As you all know, it amount is quite increased in cases who are chronic alcoholics, and especially the master antioxidants, which is glutathione. So glutathione, we have tried to correlate with ojas. So as the amount of glutathione is increased, we say that the ojas is also increased. So as you all know, the chronic alcoholism can severely impair the OGIS. And coming to treatment in case of alcoholism, in case of acute intoxication, if the patient is fit, one can definitely go with Sadhyavamana. But one need to be very careful while doing Sadhyavamana not to cause any injuries or any blood vomiting, etc. There should not be any esophageal varices, portal hypertension, and so they should be ruled out before you post the patient for Vamana. And in case of a chronic dependence patient, the Kapha Pradhana type of Madhyatya can be given Vamana, the Pitta Pradhana can be given Virechana, and Vata Pradhana can be given Basti. Though classically, Virechana is contraindicated for the patients of Madhyatya, but this contraindication is only relative contraindication for the acute intoxication, not for chronic intoxication. So those who are fit for Virechana and those who are not in acute intoxication, one can go with Virechana. But one to be very, very careful, because, and one more important condition with alcoholism is the alcoholic liver disorders. So a lot of patients come with hepatitis or increased bilirubin, ascites, etc., jaundice. So this is a common condition that we come across. So in such conditions, we generally go with Dipana Pachana, Rukshana, and Virechana. And you can see that there could be a dramatic change in their bilirubin level, in their lipid profile, in cases of in just by 1 week. I can just show you some of the reports where we are able to reduce the bilirubin from 5 to 1 in a span of 1 week. So for which we have, especially of, there's one problem with this addiction is the craving. So we have come out with one novel drug called as Dhatura Lavana. So Dhatura Lavana is a preparation where the initially the kashaya of Dhatura is prepared. The part except for the fruit and seeds, the whole of the, including the roots are taken and the kashaya is prepared. And once the kashaya is prepared, it is filtered. An equal quantity of Saindhava Lavana is added and it is boiled till we get only the Lavana is left over. So this is used in the dosage of 2.5 grams daily after food with buttermilk for a period of 8 to 10 days. This is very beneficial in the cases of anti-craving drug, which can be used very effectively in the clinical management. We also do a therapy, especially these people will have the problem with the sleep. So we also have a novel therapy called as Shiromardana, where we commonly use Ruksha Shiromardana or the Snigdha Shiromardana, where we prepare a potali of Brahmi, Sarpaganda and Jatamamsi, mix with Kshirabala Taila or Brahmi Taila and apply, or sometimes without the oil also can be applied and rubbed for 15 to 20 minutes. It is a very beneficial in reducing the acute withdrawal symptoms and also in case of inducing good sleep. Along with that, especially the problem with the motivation. In such patients who lack motivation, Dhupana is said to be very beneficial. Like simple Haridradi Dhupana, Manashiladi Dhupana, or Shilajitu, or can use the Shirishadi Dhupana are said to be beneficial in the, because as you all know, the nasal route is a very potent drug route for the management of psychological disorders. Like either Nasya or Dhupana are said to be very, very beneficial in patients who lack motivation. So we use Dhupana and Nasya. And Nasya, generally we use Jyotishmadi Taila or Panchagavya Grita or Brahmi Grita Nasya in the management of the psychological disorders. So along with that, we also have very good experiences with usage of Purana Grita. We have done a lot of researches, especially on different types of Purana Grita, and especially its usage in the form of the Nasya. 8 drops is very beneficial in chronic depression or in cases of patients with chronic alcoholisms and patients who are chronic patients of Alzheimer's dementia. You're able to find very good benefit by the use of the Purana Grita. We have used the Purana Grita, which is 1 year old, which we prepare in our department. So coming to the condition called as depression, see, though the typical symptoms of depression are loss of interest, hopelessness, worthlessness, social withdrawal, irritability, etc. But in country like India, we get more of somatic form of depression. Like they come with a headache, body ache, difficulty falling asleep, lack of interest in sexual activities, etc. So more of physical symptoms are generally the presenting complaints rather than the typical depression symptoms. So this we have to rule out the cause, because whether which prakriti to which they belong and what is their sattva and what whether they had any loss of the dear ones, any specific psychological stresses that they have, what about their dietary habits and their lifestyle in terms of their exercises, in terms of whether they have any diseases like Vataja Jwara, Pakshagata, Madhumeha, Arbuda, etc. or whether there is any other psychosocial causes need to be evaluated in cases of a depression. So you can divide them into various samprapti like Jivibhramsha, Dhiti Vibhramsha and Smriti Vibhramsha. And we can classify the depression into Vata dominant, Pitta dominant and Kapha dominant depression based on the causes and the symptoms. Vata dominant, generally they have a bad experience in the childhood, excessive traveling, use of mobiles, TV, etc., AC rooms. And the symptoms includes anxiety, phobia, restlessness, not able to concentrate. Pitta dominant are the causes could be violence, alcoholism, lack of sunlight. And the symptoms includes anger, irritability, insomnia, suicidal ideations, self-destruction behavior, etc. Kapha Jorumada, the cause could be overeating, lethargy, excessive sleep, watching TV, using of sleeping pills, etc. The symptoms could include lethargy, excessive sleep, staying alone, lack of motivation, etc. So the management, whenever you want to manage depression, so those who are having severe symptoms and those which are chronic, Vamana is the first line of treatment. Those which have those patients who are mild to moderate, Virechana could be the line of treatment. And the chronic patients, one can go for Basti. And whenever they lack motivation, you need some stimulant, Nasya, either the Pradaman Nasya or Masha Nasya using Tikshna Aushadis like Panchagavya or the Dashanadi Grita can be advocated. So there are a lot of single drugs which are beneficial as a potent antidepressants like Eshtimadhu, Shitavari, Tulsi, etc. And there are a lot of compound medications which we use in depression like Manasamitravati, Panchagavya Grita, Ashwagandha Rishta, Sarasvarishta, which are very beneficial in the treatment of depression. So along with this, I think psychological support or the Sattvaja Chikitsa plays a very, very major role in the management of psychological disorders, like in the form of giving them the support, giving them the care and creating a clear knowledge about differentiating the right and wrong, true and false, the imagined and the truth is very, very important. And more than that, and helping them to change their behavior, modify their behavior, which have been distressing, disturbing, and which are maladaptive in nature. So once a therapist or a counselor or a healer helps them, it is very important they can be easily be managed. See, these mental disorders are not rare disorders. In fact, various celebrities or various film actors, various sports person also have been suffering with various disorders, various psychological disorders, and they have been able to come out of this. The only thing that you need in case of psychological disorders is to take the help from the right people at the right time, and probably you'll be able to come out of these problems. And the most important ingredient of, because changing the behavior is very important, and that's what probably this 21 days of lockdown has helped us to understand ourselves and make the change for the behavior. So the three important ingredient of changing a behavior is self-awareness, motivation, and emotional intelligence. If an individual can focus on himself, motivate the self, and probably understand the sequelae of these changes, probably this could be an important or necessary ingredient of changing any behaviors. Indulging in lifestyle skills like yoga, meditation, pranayama, at least for 20 to 30 minutes, 5 days a week on a regular basis can be very beneficial, not only in the maintenance of health, but also in cases of because as you all know, the physical movements or the exercises will release endorphins, and these are the happy hormones which are important to keep a person happy and healthy. So there is one important bit of tip I'd like to give, how to prevent mental disorders, which I commonly call it as ABCD 4321. A is being away from distractions. So there are so many social media giving all lot of stuffs, but you need to be careful with usage of these stuffs. Always use the authentic sources for the information. A stands for away from distractions, especially at present, at being locked down at home. I think the media is very important thing that, but you should be judicious in its usage. B is better planning, understand the priorities of life. C is being cheerful. It's very, very important that you should take each and every opportunity to be happy, to be cheerful, to enjoy the things of life. D stands for daily exercises. A stands for away from distraction. B is better planning of life. C is being cheerful. And D stands for daily exercise. 4321, where it refers to 4 liters of water. In other words, sufficient water, hot water, lukewarm water. 3 times timely balanced home food. 2 times prayer, meditation, or yoga. And at least have 1 recreational activities which is going to keep you going. Maybe drawing, painting, singing, dancing, watching movies, going for travel. It could be anything. At least have 1 recreational activity which is going to keep you happy and healthy. So because, dear friends, true health is not just absence of disease. It is health is a full expression of life. Enjoy your life. Make it worth living. And to summarize the important conditions, I would like to summarize like for Unmada or various psychotic disorders, the Shodhana which are beneficial are Mustadi Apanavasti for Vataja type, Virechana for Pitaja type, and Vamana for Kafaja type. The Shamanaushadi beneficial for Unmada are for Vataja, go with Kalyanaka Grita, Pitaja, Kushmanda or Brahmi Grita, and for Kafaja, one can go with Panchagavya Grita. And the type of Sattvavaja that they require is insight oriented therapies, family supportive psychotherapies, and the family and marital therapies that will be beneficial. For Apasmara, the type of Shodhana required as for Vataja, Mustadi Apanabasti, Pittaja and Kafaja, one can go with Virechana. Generally, Vamana can be avoided until unless it's absolutely necessary for the patients. In Vegakalina, one can use Sanya Prabodhana Chikitsa like Vacha, Katfala, Churna, etc. And especially the care to avoid the injuries are at most thing. In case of the Vegantara Kalina Chikitsa, for Vataja Apasmara, Kalyanaka Grita, for Pitaja Apasmara, Brahmi Grita, and for Kafaja Apasmara, Vachadi or Mahapanchagavya Grita are said to be beneficial. One can definitely use Smriti Sagar Rasa, Vata Kulantaka Rasa in the management of Apasmara. And especially the psychotherapies or the psychological support is training the patient to live with epilepsy is very important. For the insomnia, one can use various forms of Murdhi Tailas using Shirabala Taila, Brahmi Taila, Tungadrumadi Taila, etc. Sarpagandavati, Mamsadi Kwatha, Sastarishta are said to be very beneficial. And the type of psychotherapies that you should use are the sleep hygiene techniques, like the time to sleep, the place to sleep, what you should do before sleep, what you should not do before sleep. All these are the instructions or the guidelines one should give to the patients. In case of Madhyateya, one can use Vamana and Mrudu Anulomana can be used. And you should use the combination of anulomana, yakrut uttejaka and medhya rasayana in the management of alcoholic and substance abuse. A good combination of anulomana, yakrut uttejaka and medhya rasayanas. And regarding the psychological therapies or support, the cognitive behavioral therapies, the motivation enhancement therapies, the family therapies are to be beneficial. For the patients of anxiety disorders, virechana and murdhitalas are said to be very beneficial. The shamanaushadhis like ashwagandha, tagara, brahmi are said to be beneficial. The techniques that you should teach them are relaxation techniques like deep muscular relaxation, yoga, meditation, etc. are said to be beneficial. For the patients suffering with depression, one can use vamana and nasya karma. And the shamanaushadhis, which includes jyotishmagitela, jatamamsi, brahmi grita, vamsyadi grita and purana grita, are said to be beneficial in the management of the depression. And the psychotherapies useful are supportive psychotherapies and dynamic activities and the motivation enhancement therapies. To conclude, one need to be nityam hita ahara vihara sevi samikshakari vishyeshu asaktaha dataha samaha satyaparaha kshamavan aptopasevicha bhavanti aroga. Regular intake of balanced diet, regular activities, being analytical, being detached from the worldly attachments, being kind and helpful, mental equanimity, being truthful, respecting your teachers, elders, can make a person away from various types of disorders. So let me take this opportunity to thank the organizers and all the office bearers for giving me this opportunity to present a few of my clinical experiences in the management of common mental disorders. So I'll be very happy to take up a few questions before we could wind up with the sessions. Probably there's one very interesting question as what can be done for patients suffering with stress anxiety or exam anxiety. See, the most important thing in case of any stress can be because of two major causes. One is demand and the second one is resources. If a person is able to, if there is increased demands and if a person has reduced resources, then it becomes the cause for stress. So the management also is only two. One is either reducing your demands or you can always increasing your resources. In cases of exam stress management, you cannot avoid exams. Exams are inevitable causes of evaluation. Definitely you're going to have the exams. What you can do is prepare for the exams by using the techniques of various learning techniques, memory improving techniques, and along with that, probably if you can read from the beginning. See, very important thing is we have to read, write, repeat, and rehearse, revise, and write the questions. And very importantly is you can also have a good environment for reading. If you can have a good environment for reading, work out with the proper advices of your teachers and make a constant efforts and understand your potentials, where you are strong, what is the type of reading that suits you, what's the time that suits you, and what are the different techniques that can be used. If you can use appropriate techniques, I think you can definitely manage these problems. So the management of geriatric depression. See, probably this is one of the major problem that we face nowadays with the increased old age. People definitely who are very active, who have their financial support, who have their own work, suddenly because of the retirement or because of the age, physical problems, and because of various physical and psychological disorders, they end up with having depression. So it is very important, though you may age, it's important that you keep yourself young. So, because aging happens to the body, but the mind and the individual can always be young. So, always advise a person that you should always tell that I am 70 years young, not telling that I am 70 years old, because you are still young and you have the experience of 70 handsome years of the life. So you are a very experienced person who can definitely manage the problems. So that is where the family plays a very important role. Along with that, definitely the therapies like Jyotishmati, Pratimashanasya, or the Shodhana line of treatment can be beneficial. But more than that, I think one can have a good support from the family, which could be beneficial in the management of psychological disorders. So there, I think, how can we overcome the addiction of gadgets, especially of children? I think this is a problem of most of the mothers and parents across the world. I get patients across the world asking for suggestions for this problem. See, it's very important for them. See, why they get addicted to such problems is they get enjoyment. So that's the reason why you should replace such gadgets with something which could be very enjoyable to them. At the same time, see, parents are said to be models for the children. Very often we advise them that you should not use mobiles for a longer time and you should not play with that. But right from the time we enter inside the house and play, we spend a lot of time with the mobiles. So probably if we could be the role models for the children and tell about that these mobiles or gadgets are just a mode of information or communication, not the entire entertainment, probably it can be very important to come out of this problem. So we should have a replacement. So play with the children, spend quality time with the children, fix a time for them to use. And see, technology and gadgets also has the positive side, which we cannot deny. So probably help them to choose such areas where you can always try to take the positive, but be the role models for the children. See, the problem of managing the alcohol withdrawal symptoms, especially in the scenario of lockdown. I think this is one of the very important conditions which we are facing nowadays is withdrawal symptoms because of restriction that the government has. Either there is no supply or the patient are not going to allow to go outside. Most of the, 90% of the condition get self-managed. It could be only minor problems like irritability, lack of sleep, tremors, etc. But only the rest 10% are something very serious, where they could have delirium tremors or epileptic attacks, or they could have hallucinations, which are something very serious, which needs the intense management or inpatient management. Most of the patients, you can always advise for the nutritional therapies, especially like you can ask them to go for large doses of asavarishtas like pipalyasava, draksharishta, up to 50 ml thrice a day can be given with equal quantity of water. And along with that, I think one more important therapies which can be used is the Kharjuradi Mantra. See, it is very interesting to know that this Kharjuradi Mantra is a very nutritious supplement and rich in fructose. And fructose is very important for quick transformation of acetaldehyde into acetic acid, because the most of the negative or harmful effects of the body is because of aldehydes. And aldehyde can be quickly transformed into acetic acid in the presence of fructose. So the withdrawal symptoms will be dramatically reduced whenever you are able to give the nutritional supplement in the form of Kharjuradi Mantra. Only care to be taken is a person should not be uncontrolled diabetic. Otherwise, you can easily manage withdrawal symptoms by nutritional therapies, supportive psychotherapies, and use of anti-craving drugs like Brahmi, Yashtimadhu, Jyotishmati, etc. Being the head of the department of Manasroga and the dean of research, can you please share some of the valuable research is going on in the field of Manasroga? I think I'll be very happy to share a few of the researches which has been going on. I think one of the very important area where we have been trying to focus nowadays is the literary research and fundamental research. As you all know, we lack the diagnostic tools for various diseases, and we don't have assessment, Ayurvedic assessment criteria. So for the last few years, we are trying to develop the diagnostic tools. We have been at present more than 5-6 PG as well as PhD researchers. As you all know, ours happens to be one of the very few centers which offers PhD in Ayurveda along with PG in Manasroga, along with the other 5 centers in India. In our center especially, we are doing researches on developing the scales for depression. We are trying to develop scales for Sattva Pariksha. We are developing the scale for Manasika Prakriti. We are developing the scale for the diagnosis of Nija Unmada and Aganshya Unmada. We are developing a scale for the psychological component of Sharika Prakriti. So these are some of the literary or the fundamental research that we have been at present we have been trying to do in our department. Apart from this, we have been trying to develop some of the products for alcoholic disorders. Like we have done a experimental, analytical and a clinical study of a product which we have developed called as Sumukti. It is an indigenous product which is a combination of the Trifala, Draksha, Twak, Ela Maricha, Kirata Tikta, Kuduchi and Bringaraja, which is said to be very beneficial in the management of acute and chronic alcoholic disorders, and also like chronic viral disorders and conditions. We have been using even chronic skin disorders. We have been trying to use this, and we have done extensive research with the support of Rajiv Gandhi University. A research project is being done, and we are in the process of being submitting this project and patent this product from our institution. And along with that, we have very good experiences in the clinical management of Unmada, Apasmara, Atatva Vinivesha, in cases of conditions like depression, anxiety, and insomnia. So insomnia, I think some of the very good therapies at present is Kamala Bija Churna. We are using 5 grams twice a day with milk. We are also using Yashtimadhu Churna of 3 grams twice a day with milk in case of alcohol withdrawal symptoms. We are using the combination of Shankarpushpi and Yashtimadhu in the management of anxiety disorders. And we are using various forms of the Murni Tailas in the management of psychological disorders, especially the anxiety disorders. So this is some of the researches that has been going on in our research. You can also visit our website, college website, where all the publications. I'm very happy to, as a dean of research, I'm very happy to say that we have published more than 1,200 scientific articles in peer-reviewed journals, and we have post-graduation in 15 departments, PhD in 6 departments. Please visit our website, www.sdmcahhasan.org. I repeat, www.sdmc for college, A for Ayurveda, H for Hasan, Hasan, HASSAN.org, where all the information related with the upcoming research works and all the information like you'd like to know about the courses offered and all the information about the hospital facilities, all the information that you all the upcoming events are being posted here. We also are available on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, official pages. You can kindly follow and get all the latest information that you require to know about our institution. So I think probably It's time now that I humbly extend my gratitude to all the office bearers for giving me this opportunity to share few of my experiences and my department, my colleagues, my alumni, my students' experiences with you all. Will be very happy to answer to any of your questions. You can also mail me at drsuhashetty@gmail.com. And if at all you need any help in terms of management of any disorders or any help in terms of Ayurvedic management of psychological disorders, me and my team will be very happy to help you. And you can please note down Dr. Suha Shetty, drsuhashetty at gmail.com. Kindly mail me your feedback about today's presentation. And also, if you have any queries, you can always get us back. And thank you once again for this wonderful opportunity. I thank all the office bearers of Nepal Ayurvedic Medical Student Society for this opportunity. So thank you. Namaste. Stay home, stay safe, and enjoy the series of webinars being hosted by this organization. Thank you.